Hey y'all, I had to do this video real quick because I saw a video on my timeline from Inside Edition, and it says a 35-year-old mom died from drinking too much water. You see how I hesitated on that word? Why is it that I see a lot of certain content creators? I'm gonna say that, and y'all can understand what I'm saying. Feel weary about using certain words, but you see other content creators use the words clearly, easily, and even in their titles. Okay, anyway. So they're saying that this woman, 35-year-old mom, died from drinking too much water, right? This was posted a day ago. Now, this video got 503K views. I just now paid attention to the views, but that's a lot of people. This is a popular news station. And y'all know I be in them comments. I don't know what's wrong with me. But when you listen to the video and you look through the comments, you got plenty of people in here who know a little better. But you also have people in here who like, oh, I gotta slow down on my water intake. Basically, that's their, that's their scare because I don't want to drink too much water. I didn't know you could drink too much water. So hydration is tricky. Okay. Now we're gonna go to the, now what well, okay, first let me tell you what my problem is with this video and why I'm doing this quick video. They simply stated that this woman was with her family. I think they were on the water. I'm not sure, but they were in the hot sun. She said she was extremely dehydrated, and they say she, I want to say, chugged or guzzled down 4 bottles of water. So she drank too much water too quickly. Okay. And she eventually died, which was, very soon after that. So they're trying to say, be careful about your water intake. What? This is very irresponsible, but at this point in life, y'all, 2023, this is what we expect. We should expect to be misinformed, and we should have the intuition to, if we hear something, oh, okay, and categorize it as it could be true, it could be not, it could be a little of something in the middle. And there's more to it. Now, if you choose to give it some more thought, you should research it. Now, I'm gonna go a step further. I'm gonna tell you on a metaphysical level, okay, on a cranial level, if you take it in, you should at least do some basic research. You know why? Because you've already fed it to your subconscious brain. You can walk away being unsure whether that information is true or not, but your brain has already been fed that information. So, therefore, you're going to start to implement that into your life, and it can cause you harm. Right? So, let's go and find her story. Okay, Monticello woman dies from water toxicity, and her family is raising awareness. Well, that is very good of them. What is their awareness
While it
message?
has cooled off a bit compared to last week,
Sorry, I wasn't asking you. Their message is that water toxicity happens when you drink water too fast. Now, I've checked a couple of more stories. This is basically what the media is putting out. I don't know whether the family knows better or not. I haven't interviewed them. And let's be clear, we don't know exactly what happened to this woman. We weren't there. We're not her family. We're not her. We're not her doctor. We don't know her state. We don't know what was going on that day. We don't know what she consumed, and we don't know what was in that water. Right? We just have what is given to us. The woman was saying she was dehydrated. They were in the sun, and she drank 4 bottles of water. That is about 6.9 ounces, so that's the 64 ounces of water in a short amount of time, I guess back to back. Because what's gonna happen is, and I'm an outdoors person, so I'm out there a lot. When you feel thirsty like that, When you know you're extremely thirsty, you are dehydrated. And when you feel dehydrated like that, the water doesn't quite seem to quench you, or you don't have enough time for your body to properly absorb the water and feel quenched. So yeah, you're gonna keep drinking most of the time, unless you know that if I keep drinking this water right now, it's going to get me. It could be bad for me. This is my fault. 9 times out of 10, if you're ever dehydrated, you're a whole adult, it is your fault. It's not necessarily what they tell you, what the doctors tell you, what the media tells you. It's about what you know about what your body truly needs, because you're going to be told all kinds of stuff to sell a product, to create a patient, to who knows. But there are all kinds of reasons why we are always deceived. And thank you, YouTube, for demonetizing my channel. This battle has been so annoying. And I'm just throwing this in here. This battle has been so annoying. So I can now, to some degree, we're going to see how this go, say things I want to say, talk about things I want to talk about, and not just, you know, say it, talk about just stuff that I really don't care about, but maybe I had a thought about it anyway. And you can't tell me that it doesn't align with your advertisers. So you block it, you tell me to take it down, you give me strikes for it, you give me warnings for it, and you remove the video. Or, you know, there is a chance that they will tell me that it violates their practices or their policies, whatever, because they don't want the information out. I've had videos I did about baking soda, hydrogen peroxide, castor oil, all these type of informational videos, because originally, if you go back and look at the first interview I ever did on YouTube, but that was my goal here to, you know, put out information, helpful information. YouTube has taken my videos down, give me warnings, give me strikes for it, and they will do anything in the world to try and push you to another direction. It has been a long battle, and I'm gonna do a video getting into that a little bit more here, but right now, you know, the spot is hot, so I'm just gonna kind of chill on that. But just as I'm making this video, I just want to say thank you to YouTube, because 9 times out of 10, I would have just passed it up, because they would have had something to say about it. They would have said, oh, we found that this video isn't suitable, and it's, you know, not going to be okay, we can't let this go. Or, you know, most of the time they just take the video down, and then they send me a notice, and I can't see what video they're talking about, because they don't give me a title or a date. They just said, well, actually it is a date, but it could be like a long time ago. I don't know what video they're talking about. I just know that, you know, some of my videos are gone, and that happens a lot. However, I probably would have thought twice about doing this video, because I didn't want to go through the hassle. But here we go. Okay. And listen, this is the thing. YouTube is going to put commercials on your channel anyway, whether you're monetized or not. Okay. When YouTube hit my channel, I probably had not even $300. So it's not like the money is gravy. And listen, that came from the recent spike I had. And that's what they didn't like. They never want my channel to be big in any way. So they really cut short my intentions on YouTube years ago. I'm talking about documentaries that I spent time putting together, and they would shut them down each and every time. Each and every time. Especially when I make it look, you know, more professional, because they know people are going to come see. So a lot of times I just open up and, like now, and just do a, you know, just do, boom, do a video. Don't even try to spice it up in a package, because they think, well, you know, ain't too many people going to look at that, because people want to be dazzled, entertained, and all that kind of stuff. And that's true. That's true. But at the end of the day, let's get back to this. Okay, so the family of 35-year-old Ashley Summers is raising awareness about water toxicity. Okay, on the 4th of July weekend, Summers was out at a lake at Lake Freeman near Monticello with her husband and her two daughters. She loved being on the water. She loved being on the lake, said Devon Miller, Ashley's brother. Miller says that they were there Saturday through Tuesday. It was Tuesday evening when he got a call that something wasn't right. My sister Holly called me and she was just an absolute wreck. She was like, Ashley is in a hospital. She has brain swelling. They don't know what's causing it. They don't know what they can do to get it to go down. And it's not looking good. Earlier that day, Summer's family says she was feeling dehydrated and like she couldn't drink enough water. She was lightheaded and had a headache. Listen, if you are drinking and you're still hydrated, common sense should tell you that, okay, this isn't hydrating me. Either that or maybe I should wait and give it time. Because we all know that we can shock our bodies possibly with too much of something unexpectedly, right? And too fast. We all know that what's the saying? Too much of anything isn't a good thing. That's likely to be true. Okay, I can tell you by the amount of chocolate I just ate. It was a little too much. Okay, I OD. I'm feeling it right now, but you know, I think I'm gonna be all right. I'm just telling you, even water, right? That's always been the saying, even water, and there are reasons for that. There are reasons for that. So somewhere along the line, whoever else was with her, somebody didn't have the, you know, I guess knowledge to say, whoa, you know? And I'm going to tell y'all from doing research, from experience, I have been thirsty for years and I stay drinking water. I don't drink water as much as I used to anymore. And I almost never drink plain water. I had to learn a lot. I was like, maybe I got diabetes. Can you test me for this? Test me for that. Trying to see why I'm always drinking water. This could have easily happened to me. I'm telling y'all. And still thirsty, let alone getting outside sweating. It's like, okay, I'm thirsty. Boom, boom, boom. Guzzling water. It's not working. At least I had the wherewithal to say, okay, I'm going to stop. Because I can't just keep drinking this water like this. Okay. So someone said she drank 4 bottles of water in 20 minutes. Now, some people are out there being just all up in arms. Oh, that's a lot. That's a lot. It can be. In 20 minutes. Yeah, that's just like, I don't know. That could almost be described as taking a hit of something strong. Like, I don't know if you hit the blunt, you hit the crack pipe. You can imagine that that's a rush for your body. 20 minutes. And I'm not going to say I haven't done it or something close on several occasions. There are plenty of things that could have gotten me before I even understood what was going on with my body and what it needed instead of what I was trying to do. And hydration was a big one. A big one. So, again, it's supposed to be like 16 ounces in each bottle. 16.9 is some. We don't know what water she had. And while we're at it, let's also not forget, ever forget, the many reports that have been put out about these water companies, how they've been tested, how they have all kind of stuff in them, right? Because a lot of people easily think, oh, they putting all this in the tap water? Cool, I'm going to go buy bottled water. Hold up a second. What makes you think that they are not going to put it in the water bottle because they know you're going to go for that thinking you good? They want you to have it in your body. That is why they are putting in the fall. I don't care how they disguise it and say, oh, we need to do this to treat the water, blase, whatever. They want to treat you as well. Okay. We've seen reports to where the water source was not what it was stated when they claimed to have certain things like minerals or alkaline and stuff like that. That isn't the case, right? And you guys can do your research on that. I'm not going to get all the way into it, but let's keep that in mind as well. We don't know what the water was that she drank. And this is what they are saying. So we're going to go ahead and assume she did drink 4 bottles of water, which is equivalent to about 64 more ounces in 20 minutes. Okay, now, it goes on to say that's half a gallon. That's what you're supposed to drink in a whole day. Ashley made it home, but she passed out in her garage. And she was taken to IU Health Arnett Hospital, but never regained consciousness. Doctors told the family she died from water toxicity. It was a shock to us all. When they first started talking about water toxicity, it was like, this is a thing, said Miller. For them not to know it was a thing, that tells us that they didn't have the knowledge to say, okay, slow down on water or anything else. Now, it goes on to say water toxicity occurs when someone drinks too much water really quickly. There are some things that can make someone more at risk for it, but the overall theme is that it happens that you have too much water and not enough sodium in your body. Okay, now I found a spot where they're at least giving you a little bit more to go on. So this should be enough with adults with common sense for you to say, is that so? Okay, then you should look into what's this combination look like? Nobody else was saying this. Inside Edition was not giving out that information. People aren't going to go read an article or do more research on the situation. They're just going to say, wow, she drank too much water. I should cut back on my water probably, or be careful, you know, about how much water I drink. So it says Dr. Frogberg says it's a rare occurrence, but during the summer months, if you're someone that works outside or exercises a lot, it's important to have a hydration plan. I got to give this article credit. Make sure that you're drinking things that have electrolytes and sodium and some potassium. And this is what I came here to say. I did not read this article, but it's still good that it's in the article, so that at least there is a video that gives more information. Although I don't got Inside Edition clout, because that is just irresponsible and dangerous. But hey, it is a gossip site, so you know you're not gonna. They're not. So Dr. Frogberg says some of the symptoms you'll experience are feeling generally unwell, having muscle cramps and soreness, nausea and headaches. Summers was an organ donor. I'm gonna keep on reading. And was able to donate her heart, her lungs, her kidneys, her liver, and some of her long bone tissue. She helped save 5 people's lives. And listen, this is not all. They got everything. Listen, in production, they don't waste nothing. I don't, if it's a chicken, if it's a hog, if it's anything, they don't waste no parts. Okay, and we know, and if you don't, do your research, what they doing with all kind of parts of your body. So I guess they lucked out on that. But at the end of the day, this is what occurred in her situation, and it's sad. And let's find a picture of her so we can put a picture up of her. Wow. Okay, so this is Ashley. Now, if you know you're going to be out and it's hot, it is very good for you to make sure that the evening before you drink a good amount of water. And I'm saying it like that because that's not just no one size fit all for everybody. It depends on what's going on with your body, what's going on with your electrolytes, your sodium levels, your vitamins, your minerals. But for, let's say, a normal healthy person, whether you know your levels or not, you still can be needing of something else, right? to be fully hydrated. But if you are all good, you're supposed to drink up on a lot of water so your body can't have time to store and absorb that water the night before, because you're going to go and you're going to sweat and you're going to lose a lot of minerals. You're going to lose a lot of sodium. You're going to lose a lot of electrolytes. And on top of that, when you go out, yes, you can have your water, but you also need to make sure that you're having something that is going to replenish the nutrients that you are losing through all that heat, all that sweat. Then let's not even talk about mixing it with alcohol, which dries you out and depletes you even more. And you should make sure that you're maintaining regular hydration, because when you're at the point where you're extremely thirsty, you feel like you're dehydrating, you're having all these signs and symptoms, you are past the point of where water is going to help you by itself. You are past the point of being sure that you even going to be okay for the rest of the day, because it takes time for your body to get back hydrated. So you might need to go somewhere and just sit down for the rest of the day and just take your time getting back hydrated and not deplete yourself anymore. You're out and it's hot. You got to make sure you're having things that can help you. You got to make sure that you're putting back the potassium. You need some kind of salts in there. You need, you need your vitamins and minerals. I don't care if you even just simply got lemon juice. But sugary drinks isn't going to get it. That's going to help keep you even more thirsty. But you got to make sure that you're keeping your electrolyte levels balanced, because that sun is going to pull it all out of you. And when you drink too much water, your body is filtering anything that you have left. And with the brain swelling, that is something that can happen when you drink too much water too fast and your body don't have enough time to filter it out, and it doesn't have all the other minerals so it can evenly disperse it. So for them to just sit up there, that really bothered me. Like, why would you sit up there and be so irresponsible? And I get it, we should all, but come on. Most people just watch a video or hear what somebody's saying, that's it. It's unfortunate, but that's just the way it is nowadays. To sit up there and this woman is beautiful. And she looks young. What was her age? Hold on. Okay, it's saying that she's 35. I saw something with another Ashley. But I don't think that's her. They look similar. Let me go to that article. This is in Ohio. Oh, that cookies thing gets on my nerves, but. And she is in Ohio. So I'm not sure if this is her, because this was just last year. And yes, you can go to college at any age. And this one says that she is, she's a graduate with a Dean's Award, majoring in materials science. I didn't see enough about like her life outside of her being an organ donor that tells me whether or not this was her. But it says, I was attracted to Kent State because of the flexible interdisciplinary nature of the materials science program. Now, this looks like it could have been a slimmer version of her. Eye color is the same. She had gray eyes. So I'm not sure, guys. Wow. Very exciting. When I visited the campus to learn more, I found out everyone was welcoming and kind. I'll be starting my graduate education in the fall of 2022. Main goal is to learn as much as I can about everything that I can. I want to combine what I learned from my experiences from everywhere that I have been in my life. Okay, so this doesn't sound like someone who is a teenager. Besides my own personal aspirations, my goal is to be a role model for my son and encourage him to pursue his own dreams. Okay, so she's mentioning one son. Now, I'm not going to show it, but they have two children. Oh, wow. Okay, no, that wasn't her. They have two daughters. Wow. Okay. So, you know, this is unfortunate. And guys, just know next time you should go do get your hormones checked, you know, with that. Because some things that they're saying are vitamins or minerals, they're actually hormones. Like, let's say vitamin D, that is a hormone. And that is why you can get that, absorb that from the sun, because it's a hormone. So you need to know where your electrolyte levels are and where your vitamin and mineral levels are, and you can have a deficiency like I do, which you don't, you're not at the healthy level on your own or on a normal basis. So yeah, in my case, this could have happened to me because water was never gonna cut it by itself, and that's what I was on for years. I wouldn't even really hardly mess with anything else besides water, and that was like one of the worst things for me to do. So when you have anything you're taking in too fast, your kidneys has to deal with that. And it's shocking that a lot of people drink a lot of liquor and beer quickly, and they do fine. But it has a lot of stuff in it too, you know? So you got to think about what plain water can do, which is take a lot of stuff with it. You know, it's like it could really, it's supposed to help. It's supposed to aid in spreading out, you know, the potassium, the minerals, the electrolytes, everything that your body needs. But your kidney still has to filtrate and process everything and then pass it around and then eliminate. So that's some figuring out that your organs have to do. That you should be easy on them. I think if we all think about it, we should be a lot easier on our organs because they have a lot of work to do and their job never stops. Even when you're fasting, they're still working hard because there's something there and there's a process going on. And the heart itself never ever stops from what, 4 to 6 weeks in the womb. So think about that. Everything has to be filtered through the kidney, through the organs, I mean the liver, you know, and pancreas and all of that stuff, and they have to figure out what it is so that they can filter it, process it, pass it on, and then filter it out. And they gotta move quickly because of at the rate that you're probably bringing stuff in. In my opinion, we all eat and drink too much and too much of what we're not supposed to have. So a lot of us are lucky to even be doing good. Another tip, and this is kind of off, but still, chew, 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 chew. Chew it up, swish it around, chew it up. Let your mouth obliterate it. You got all these things going on in your mouth for a reason. There is no teeth in your stomach. There's no teeth in your stomach, so what, however you swallow it, that's all of that's got to be broken down by basically juices. Also, your body, while it's breaking it down, is trying to figure out what it is so they can know what to do with it. And that was your job. You had one job, two. The first one is to make better choices. The second one is to take your time and chew and break it down. Because everything going on in your mouth is in dissecting everything out down to the seasoning. And it's sending signals to your brain. Okay, we got some lemon pepper in here. We got some butter in here. We got some leafy greens. We got some, and we mix a lot of combinations of food that we're not supposed to mix, but that'll never stop. That's another story. Hey, that's even more the reason why you need to break it down. We got some bread in here, we got some cheese in here, and all your organs has to process all of that and try to extract what it can out of it that it could use, and then the rest of it has to send it to the proper filtration systems so that it can probably get rid of it. So while you're sending those signals, you're chewing and you're breaking it down, your tongue, everything is getting gathering what these things are. These are fats, these are fibers, these are this, and it's sending the signal to your brain, and your brain is sending out, okay, everybody get ready, pancreas get ready. We got some just some sweetness over here. You know, all of this kind of stuff. And that helps a lot. A lot. So think about that too. And, you know, our condolences to Ashley and her family for this tragic event. Y'all choose wisely out here. Peace.